but we know how to communicate. Because if I say a party happening at the union, I'm going to send out one text message. It's going around the whole school in 20 minutes. So we know how to put it all together, right? So that's kind of where I want us to really get them to, is like developing them and like showcasing. Recruiting isn't about the offer, because you can get recruited anywhere. Anybody can recruit you. And you can't base it solely off of, well, they won a national championship 5 years ago. And you can't base it on, well, they facilities like this. And you can't base it on, well, because if everybody offering you a full ride, then it's not about money. Mm-hmm. So if everybody giving you a full ride, then that means you go to school for free. Don't matter, right? So it's like, okay, what am I getting out of this?
For sure.
And that's the career side. And as a coach, recruiter, a scout, I got to know what this kid likes. I got to know what this kid is interested in. What do you want to major in and why? Because then that also helps me with directing them to the right person for NIL.
Prime example, Coach Dawn Staley, and that recruit that she got. I don't know her. I was looking at it, and her name is escaping me. The young lady, I'm going to find her name. I'm going to get it because I just want to put some respect on it.
Yeah, because she a baller, too, from what I saw on the thing. I don't know her name either.
Dawn Staley gets recruit and creates major. What is this young lady's name? We want to get her. Coach Dunn Staley had South Carolina create a major in environmental engineering to get 6'2 forward Joyce Edwards to commit to SC.
Yeah.
Has a 5.0 GPA and averaged 31 points and 13 rebounds.
Baller. Academic baller. And know what she wants to do career-wise. So if I'm Coach Dawn, okay, check, check, check. Now all I gotta do is do the physical part. Because all that stuff is done.
That is true, she ready.
All I gotta do is get in, I'm in the game. I already got her degree laid out, cool. Academic, laid out. Mentally, I understand where her mindset is at, so I'ma continue to feed that. So I gotta make sure she gonna be straight. So physically, we gonna run drills, we gonna practice, we gonna play games, and we just hit all four joints. We just won. But that's a real coach.
That's it. That is a real coach. And I was talking with somebody about this the other day, and we're talking about how, or it might have been you. we're talking about how players can yell at players because they get frustrated that they don't understand what's happening. But then on the other side, it's, well, you can't be mad at them. You're not mad at them because they're not playing how you're supposed to play. You're mad at yourself because you're just not coaching. Coach.
Yeah.
Just do your job.
People don't understand coaching is not just a title. Like, if I'm coaching you, I'm assisting. I'm helping.
Yeah.
Like, I see, I'm drawing these plays, and you looking in the sky like, you stressed out like, bro, I don't know what's going on. Because we forget that coaching and teaching are all the exact same thing. Because a teacher in class is going to be like, yeah, guys, X squared plus B squared equals C squared. And then you just doing the thing like, looking lost. A good teacher going to be like, yo, see me out of it. I'm out of the class.
Mm-hmm.
A good teacher.
Yeah.
So a good coach should be like, yo, we did the film study. We did the whiteboard. We did the on-field, on-court. Still ain't got it. What's going on?
Then that's the part where you really got to coach, because then you have to identify, how does this guy or gal best learn?
How do they learn?
Are they kinetic? Or are they visual? Or are they auditory? Like, how can I break it down for them? But if you ain't taking that time, or you don't want to take the time, then you're not going to get the maximum result of that investment.
Did you hear what Matt Rhule said about when he was sitting with Belichick? He said Belichick spoke for 4.5 hours on football. And he was like, I was so embarrassed. Because he was just making the complex stuff simple. Because guys like that, they learned the game, they ingested it, and they can bring it back out to where it makes sense. All these other guys are trying to speed through to become the next best coach and don't know how to coach. They know how to regurgitate what they heard at a clinic. Let's do these drills. Why are we doing these drills? All right, cool. Look, let's do these cone joints. Why are we doing that? You can't even relate the drills to your scheme because you don't understand the scheme.